Everybody, this is NDM here, welcoming you back to another episode of Let's Play Mother 25th Anniversary Edition. Okay, so in the last episode, we spent a lot of unnecessary, not needed time in Reindeer looking for a weapon for Lloyd that was completely non-existent. I thought that the Death Beam and the Laser Beam were equipable items for Lloyd, but it turns out that they're not. They're just weapons that basically serve the same purpose as a bottle rocket. And then we made our way to Snowman and also got a hat in our inventory, which needs to be given to a girl located in Snowman, which is Anna, of course. yeah, there's no big surprise there. I'm not really spoiling anything. Why is there a blue gravestone here? Is this a suspicious-looking gravestone? Do we have to check it? Oh, no, let's try using PSI on it for some... for whatever reason, I don't know, just to see. Nintendo's telepathy, nothing happened. That's kind of weird that there's just one blue gravestone there, but that must be like a missing texture glitch thing, whatever. Something that the emulator just can't fix, I guess. Yeah, because emulation sometimes does that, like it has missing textures show up every now and then. It's just a glitch, basically. Even if you play the original Metroid on the NES, and you play it on... You can even play it on the Virtual Console, on the Wii U, because I actually have Metroid on NES on the Virtual Console for the Wii U, and you play it on there, sometimes there are like blocks that you'll come across as you scroll down the massive hallways that go down and up. If you jump all the way down those, sometimes you'll see like really weird looking colorations on the wall. Like some blocks will be colored differently, and it's just completely random what color they are and like in what position of the wall that they show up in. It's just something that's basically a glitch. There's nothing more to say about it really. Lloyd leveled up, guts rose by 1, speed rose by 1, status rose by 4, vitality rose by 2, IQ rose by 5, HP rose by 8. Yeah, if I ever do Metroid on NES again, I'll point it out to you, because it happens on emulator, it happens on pretty much everything, it happens on... probably even happens on the original cartridge. I don't know, I don't own a Nintendo Entertainment System, although I would love to own one, but they're... well, they're not hard to get hold of, and they're not really that expensive, I don't think. It's just like, I've been collecting a lot of N64 games, and kind of been collecting GameCube games as well recently, so I haven't been focusing on too much on other consoles besides that, so. Well, there was nothing here, it was just a dead end, so let's get out of here and try and find another way around this place. Yeah, that was Bigfoot that we just fought then, I thought I'd just point that out. Talking about the enemies that we were facing. I was talking about other things, and Bigfoot, I guess, can actually use PSI. I didn't think that enemies at this stage of the game could use PSI to attack you. I guess I was wrong, because he can use Freeze Alpha. But Freeze Alpha isn't that big of a deal. It's when they start using Freeze Beta and stuff like that, and Freeze Gamma. And that's the kind of stuff you want to watch out for. But you won't have enemies attacking you with fire until you get to Mount Itoy, I think. Unless the Nancy enemies in the desert can attack you with fire, I honestly can't remember. Let's have a look and see where we are on the map. We're right in the very bottom right-hand corner. And we're going to go into the chapel, which is where Anna is. And there's a priest here, too. My daughter Anna is a little timid, but she has a kind heart. Mysterious power. Alright, let's talk to her and see what she wants. Obviously the hat. You know, I had a dream about someone who looked like you. Okay, do I just use it? Intent, right? Yeah. I've been waiting for you. I need your help to find my mother. Let's start by seeing what's happening in Easter. Dad, goodbye for now. Next time I see you, Mum will be with me. Please pray for us. She should be level 20. Oh, she's level 20. She's not level 22. Unfortunately, let's see what PSI moves she has. Because she's going to have some. She has Life of Beta. And she has Telepathy. She doesn't know any PSI techniques. She doesn't know Freeze yet. She doesn't know PK Beam. All the essentials she doesn't have, which kind of sucks. I guess we're going to have to get her up a few more levels before she starts learning those techniques. Because PK Beam is kind of an essential, you will need that, especially for the later areas of the game. Freeze is also an essential. Any PSI move is really good, so... I don't know, I might have to do a bit of grinding here, actually. But I guess we can make an episode of it. We can just do some grinding in this video, and then in the next episode we can make some progress. And go to the next area, which is going to be Halloween. That will be the next place we'll need to be headed. But before we go fighting wild monsters, I highly advise that you buy Anna a weapon, even though she's mostly magic constrained. Magic constrained, I don't think that's the right word, but magic restricted. She's, yeah, basically magic restricted. But what I mean by that is that she mostly gets her attack damage from using spells and stuff like that. She doesn't use, like, I wouldn't advise using physical attacks for her as much, unless you, of course, you run out of PP. And so the only time I would advise you to just use physical attacks, but if you can, just use magic. Because that's where Anna gets most of it. Sorry about that. Hope that didn't pick up too loud on the microphone. I just had a bit of a, something stuck in my throat. Anyway, yeah, she's mostly magic restricted, so just make sure that you have a lot of PP for her and reserved in case, like, you know, you come unstuck. Especially if you're going into a dungeon or something. Just make sure you have some magic on hand. Ah, here we go, Lone Wolf, right. She might learn some techniques after this battle, actually. We'll have to see what happens. I'm not going to pin my hopes on it, though, but maybe she might. Because those spells that she has now, I think, are preset spells. Like, those are spells that you get automatically when you first get her on your team at level 1. Like, she has those spells, but I think, like, as, obviously as you progress in levels, she gains she gets the techniques. So hopefully, because she's level 20, she'll learn all the techniques she missed out on. Yeah, she definitely did. Anna learned a new PSI power. 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 Anna PSI power. Oh my god! Another one! What a surprise. More and more and more. Just give me that shit. Hell yeah. I don't know how much longer I could have kept that up for, but she's got a lot of good spells. She's got Life of Beta, Life of Gamma, Sleep Fix, Shield Alpha, Brain Shock, Shield Off, Freeze Beta, Thunder Beta. Okay, she's got good spells. She's got really good spells. Does this mean she skipped out Freeze Alpha? That's kind of weird. Okay, I guess grinding might not be necessary then. We might not need to do that. Also, Lloyd is ridiculously low on health, but I'm going to have Anna do the healing. Because I need to deal as much damage as I can against these guys. So we're going to heal Lloyd here, get him some health back. We will need to grind, because we need to get money for Anna, so that she can buy the best armor, and hopefully we'll have some money to buy some pendants and stuff, because we need some pendants to boost our elemental resistance, which is a necessity. Life of Beta just to get your health back up. because I really don't want to use a hotel. I don't want to use an inn, because if we start sleeping at inns, we're going to be wasting money, valuable money that we don't need to be using. And don't bother using freeze, like any PSI freeze attack on enemies that are ice type, because it's not going to do much. And that's all I can say about that. Oh, she learned a new one now. And another one. God, how many PSI powers are you going to learn, Anna? You're going crazy here. Jesus. She learned more. See what else she learned. PP drain, blind. Oh, she learned freeze alpha. That's kind of weird. Why did she learn freeze alpha? No, freeze beta before learning freeze alpha. That doesn't make sense. Beam alpha and thunder beta. That's really weird. I don't know. What's she gonna learn? Thunder alpha? The next battle that we do? I mean, it wouldn't surprise me. Oh, never mind, there are multiple gravestones here that have blue patterns on them. It's not just that one, there's these two down here as well. And that one over there. I guess I just wasn't paying attention, because if you look at it on this screen right here, like, you can only see one of them, colored blue, but if you come over here you can see that there are more colored blue, but... yeah. Don't worry guys, I'm not colorblind. I might be snowblind, but I'm not colorblind. Let's see if we can find some more wild encounters. Bigfoot, not big deal. Let's get rid of this guy. Yeah, Anna doesn't do much damage physically, like, as you saw, she just did 1 HP of damage, which is nothing. She's learning more. I guess that should be the title of the video, Anna learns a new PSI power. That should just be the title of the video. That'd be kind of funny. Because that's all the video is Anna learning new techniques, like, just so many. Actually, we should take a look and see which ones she did learn. Sleep fix, I think, was one of them. Paralysis, another one. Wait, she didn't learn Thunder Beta yet. Antidote, I think Antidote was another one she just learned too. So we're kind of learning the essential spells here, I guess. Ones that we will definitely be needing. She hasn't learned fire yet. That's kind of strange. Fire is the one we want, because then we can use that against the ice enemies to do more damage. Especially against these freaking things right here. Lone wolf. All you can hope for with these guys is that you get a critical hit, because then that does speed the battle along quite a bit. It definitely helps. Actually, you know what? Because Anna has 103 PP, I'm going to try using, not freeze, beam alpha. See if that does anything. Yeah, I did 34 HP of damage. That's fairly good. And Nintendo gained a level. So we got guts rose by 2, speed rose by 3, states rose by 2. Vitality rose by 3, IQ rose by 3, HP rose by 2, PP rose by 2. And there we go with Anna learning new techniques again. Let's see what she learned this time. Hypnosis. Yeah, I'm pretty sure hypnosis was the one she just learned. Yeah, she should gain a level as well soon. She reaches 3000 EXP, she should gain a level. So we're gonna do beam again on Polar Bear. Just just to get through this as quickly as possible, because I don't want to deal with these things, because they can do continuous attacks. At least I think part of the bears can. I know the bears on Mount Itoi can do continuous attacks, and they are, like, they can do 89 damage per attack. So they'll do 89 damage one turn, or within one attack, and then they'll follow up on the same turn with another attack that does 89 HP of damage, which will obviously kill you. She learned something else as well. So what else has she got for us? Shield beta and shield off, I think she just learned, and thunder alpha. She's got thunder alpha now. Okay. Still don't have fire though. That's kind of perplexing. I don't know why we don't have fire yet. Right. Got $304. How much was it to stay at the inn? It was $100-something to stay there. $120, I think it was, to stay at the inn. But that was when we had Lloyd. Now that we got Anna, it's probably going to be even more expensive to stay there. So that is gonna suck. I gotta remember which way it is to get out of this place. It's over here somewhere, isn't it? Just following it down this hill. There we go. Shouldn't just stay in the inn. I mean, I'm using the money that I have on me, but see, I knew it'd be more expensive now that we got Anna on our team. Curses! At least I don't have to take that much money out, because I've got $304 on me at the moment, so I need to find the shop. Well, the shop was right next door. Dude, dummy. What's this building right here? Use the ATM card, and we'll take out whatever money we have. So we got $2,117. Well, I'm going to take out, let's just say $80 will be more than enough to compensate. So then we'll go into the inn and stay and get rest up so we can get all our HP and PP back. Such a satisfying tune. Well, it's not really a tune, it's a jingle. Tune is more like a song. That's not really a song, that's like a jingle. Something that you'd have as like a, I don't know, a phone alarm or something. Freeze alpha on who? On Anna. Well, I didn't actually do that much damage. Let's see, that only did 7 HP of damage on the weakest party member that we have on our team. And she doesn't even have any elemental resistant gear on right now. Guts rose by 1, speed rose by 1, status rose by 4, vitality rose by 2, IQ rose by 5, HP rose by 10. That's really good. Anna learned a new PSI power. Okay, is that fire by any chance? Because I really hope it is. Yeah, she's got fire. Fire alpha. Okay, that's cool. Now we can use that to our advantage. Especially against them ice enemies like the lone wolves and things like that. I don't know if fire does good against Bigfoot. It might do good damage against Bigfoot, but I'm really not sure. Well, we got a perfect test subject right here. Lone wolf, let's try and use fire on his ass. I'm gonna burn you to a crisp. That did nothing. 20 HP of damage. I was expecting to do like way more than that. Well, I guess you could say 20 is better than nothing. You know, like that, 1 HP of damage, and another 1 HP. Oh, Lloyd actually killed it. with a 1 HP attack. And I learned new PSI power. Let's see what it is. Not the map, that's the wrong subscreen. Sleep, fix. Oh, revivify. Revivify, that's not a real word. Revivify. Wouldn't you say revitalize? Revivify, revitalize. I mean, I know revitalize is a lot longer in terms of letters, but... Alright, let's try fire on a weaker enemy, so we'll try fire on these guys. Fire actually attacks all enemies on the field, so... which is good. 20, 16, and 20, so I guess 20 is about the maximum amount of damage you're gonna do with Alpha. Fire Alpha, so that kinda blows. A little bit. Because you're not gonna use fire on any other enemy in the game, really. Apart from bug-type enemies, I guess you would use fire-type moves against them. Or grass-type enemies. But you can't really tell what enemy is effective or more affected against a PSI technique than another, because what would a UFO be affected by? More fire, ice, you know, lightning? Maybe lightning, I don't know. It might do damage, like good damage to UFOs, I have no idea, but PK Beam is really the ultimate PSI technique in this game. It's just as good as Starstorm is in Earthbound, really. Hey, Anna grew to level 21. Guts rose by 1, speed rose by 2, saves rose by 4, vitality rose by 2, IQ rose by 4, HP rose by 1, PP rose by 9. Anna learned a new PSI power. She learned another one, and another one. I'm telling you, dude, they just don't stop coming. Shield off. Disable. Freeze Gamma already? Beam Beater. Alright, we're doing good. We got good spells going on right here. Some good spells. So let's try and test some of them out. I want to try and test out Beam Beater. See how well that goes. So beam. We'll do it on Wolf C, because I don't think I had someone attack Wolf C. See if it kills him. Oh yeah, 90 HP of damage, see? PK Beam is just so OP in this game, kills pretty much everything. That's why I don't really bother using the other PSI moves in this game. I don't bother using Freeze or Fire as much. I guess you would in the early stages of the game, because PK Beam consumes a lot of PP. And you kind of want to, you know, save your resources as much as you can. Instead of wasting them. So it'd be wise to not use PK Beam earlier on in the game, because you don't have as much PP as you would when you're like level 40 or 30 by the time you get towards, you know, near the end of the game. When you have a lot of PP to use. At this stage of the game, we don't really have that luxury. Alright, I think I'm gonna make this the last battle of the video, and then, I might continue grinding off screen for a little bit, and then once I've gotten Anna caught up on levels and learnt a few more spells that she has left to learn, we can start making some progress and go into the next part of the game, which will be, Halloween. That's the next town we need to go to. And I think we're more than strong enough to do that. It's just I need to grind for money to get Anna some better defense equipment. And hopefully we can buy some pendants as well. Depending on how long it takes me to do all that, I might record another episode straight after this one. If not, I'm going to record tomorrow because it's getting kind of late now, so... And it's going to take a while for me to render these videos too, so... Looking forward to that. And 23 HP, need to heal urgently. I'm going to get Lloyd some health and have Anna attack Silver Wolf D. These two won't be able to finish this off, because we're only doing 1 HP of damage per attack. Oh my god. Yikes, critical condition. Yay, Lloyd got a smash attack, sweet. Alright, that finished him off. Just in time. Oh, Nintendo now learned one. So let's see what Nintendo just learned. I think he learned Offense Up, actually. Yeah, it would seem that way. So that would be handy against boss battles, so that's good. Life up Alpha on Anna. And she can actually heal herself, to be honest, with Life up Bea, because that would get her more health back. And then the same for Lloyd, I guess. Okay guys, I'm gonna end off the video here and continue on in the next episode. So in the next episode of Let's Play Mother 25th Anniversary Edition, we shall be making our way to... Well, actually we'll be going back to Magicant to buy the items that we need to buy from there, and then we'll be making our way to Spookane. Well, originally called Spookane, but in this game it's called Halloween. So until then, this is NDM saying thanks for watching, take care, everybody, see you in the next video, and goodbye.